How are you doing, everyone? Right now, I am headed up to the NEHHA campsite. I am going a day early just because I live close enough and, I'm unemployed, so I can. I will be up there. It's Thursday right now. It's about 3 o'clock. I'm going to be up there in about 20 minutes. I'm that close to the location. And we're going to have some fun. I'm going to set up camp. I'm going to do the first thing that I've never done before. And I am going to camp solo. I decided that I'm going to start off the year right. So I'm going to set up shop tonight by myself and just enjoy it. But we have this all to ourselves. Take a look. Winter Wonderland, baby. Nice little brook over there. As you can see, it's pretty close to my setup. I've seen a little bit of tracks coming through here, so I'm curious to see what other tracks we might spy tonight. But I've got 2QZQ's breathable undercoat protector right here. And I have a 20 degree hammock gear, 3/4 length quilt for my feet. And I have a hammock gear 0 degree, 2 extra ounces of overfill, and that one. And this one's still using what they made last year, or the year before, which is the Cuban fiber mylar. It's working all right. And notice along the seam lines, it's starting to kind of spread out a little bit. So I'm having a little bit more down loft in those areas. So I'm deciding what I need to do with those. I might sacrifice the underquilt later for another one. Or see if we can't maybe tame seal tape or seam tape the seams and see if that'll help out. But and then my top, this is a DIY camo 1.1 ACU ripstop nylon, and on top I have another hammock gear. Major props to Adam and Jenny. I love their stuff. They've done and treated me really well. So I've been sticking with them for right now. But that's an M50 top and bottom, or outside inside, full length top quilt. And that one's got 3 extra ounces of overfill in it. So I should be nice and toasty tonight. I'm all hunkered down. Well, I'm not hunkered down yet. My stuff is, though. That is the War Bonnet Superfly. Had that for about a little over a year now, and absolutely love it. Right now I'm actually gonna get a fire going and start supper, and I don't know what's on the menu. I either have homemade barbecued spaghetti, that's from Babel Fish 5's recipe, that is delicious, or I also have, I think, like beef stew from Mountain House. We'll see which way I go. And I think I might just kind of sit by the fire for a while and relax and listen to the night sounds. And then I think I'm just gonna hit the bed early tonight. Get a good night's sleep, cause there is gonna be fun tomorrow. So we're gonna see you then, and stay tuned for just a lot of shenanigans, a lot of good folk, good conversation, and a fantastic time. So, good evening. It's about 5:30, 6 o'clock tonight. We have our fire going. Doesn't she look lovely? Got some firewood over there. We're cheating. My dad lives about a 5-minute drive from here, so I ran over to his house and grabbed some cordwood. That's hardwood. Yeah, oak, maple, beech, birch. So, just kind of chilling, about ready to have some dinner. I have decided to have chicken teriyaki and rice. I don't know if you can see that. That's actually pretty good. It's one of my favorites, especially from Mountain House anyways. I also have some my Whisper Light going. The difference between a normal Whisper Light, and I had talked about using this the beginning or a couple videos ago, is one of the jets for the propane, and you just take it out like a normal jet, And then the connector, this part right there, this comes off. There's a little screw right there. And you just pop that off and you pull it on an adapter. Same type of setup. It's got the shutoff valve and the fuel valve right there. And then you just screw on your canister. So it works actually really well. It was really easy to do. It takes about a minute to switch it over. Not bad at all. I've used it to cook. What's nice is you can adjust the propane on it, so you can simmer on that. And that's where the simmering aspect comes from. So, but right now I'm just kind of chilling. I have a few other things that I'm eating. I have Mountain Trail Mix. Great outdoor tradition of raisins, peanuts, almonds, cashews, and M&M chocolate candies. That's one of my favorites that goes on every trip that I go on. Also, while I was at my father's, snagged some bacon. I'm sure I'm going to see plenty of bacon. We've already talked about probably 7 pounds of bacon coming. Bacon galore.
Woo, look at that.
Good evening, everyone. It's about 8:45. I'm just kind of sitting here still by the fire. It's been a peaceful evening. Not a sound to be heard. And just kind of chilling. It's been very, very relaxing.
Got flamage!
So, I'll probably see you tomorrow morning. I'll let you know how the temperature was. And we'll get up and move around, get a fire going. We got to throw some more wood on the fire so we can hopefully have some coals in the morning. Get a fire going in the morning, have some Pop-Tarts, some oatmeal, some hot chocolate. And then we're going to put the sign out for the NEHHA guys to find their way in. Again, they're going to be coming in about 10 o'clock. And I am so looking forward to the fun, the shenanigans, the good conversations, whatever we got coming. So stay tuned. We're going to have a great time. I'm all snuggled up in my hammock, about ready to go to sleep. Very toasty warm. Probably a little too warm. I boiled up some water and put them in a hot water bottle. Two of them, actually about 60 ounces. Threw them in my hammock right before I got in. It is so nice and toasty. It's about 14 degrees, 14.6. Well, good morning, everyone. It's 7:30 Friday morning. Not a bad night's sleep, considering. First night soloing. That always puts a little bit of stress and puts your mind in hyper mode. And what is that sound? So every time the bag squeaked against the side or something like that, it was like a footprint or foot thing. Other than that, warm and toasty all night long. Comfortable. Heard some dogs barking most of the night, some coyotes running through or running around. I thought I either heard a cow moose making noise or an actual cow. I don't know if anyone in the area has them. But last night it got down to 13 degrees. Not bad. Yeah, like I said, I was warm and toasty all night long. It was fantastic. How you doing, guys? It's about 12 o'clock. 30 degrees on a beautiful Friday afternoon. We got some people finally showing up. We've got Relaxed. Old Soldier showed up. We have Stargaze and his lovely wife. And we also have Sky Painter and Matt to go along with it. So people are starting to show up. We're having a good old time so far. We got somebody throwing stuff into the in around the shelters. Starting to become home. I'm gonna show you something though. This is what you saw me making earlier. It's a tripod that we can adjust pots over the fire for hot and cold. Just a little bit of lashings. We do this all the time for our troop. Thought you might like that.
Make the fire brighter.
Make the fire brighter.
Pour gasoline, that'll make it nice and bright.
Yeah. Oh, we can do that.
I don't know if we want to do that.
Bacon, sausage, eggs.
Better than sausage reheated in bacon grease.
Pork, love, and pork.
Hey, we're getting ready for a wonderful dinner.
Meat!
Gonna cook it right in here. Can't ring off the spit.
Gotta be yummy.
Wow. Everybody had me in the
lip
running
his head.
It was like in the middle of winter.
It's just too enjoyable to watch.
I'm not going to help him. I am amused, Dan, that you had to
walk across. Good morning. It's about 8 o'clock Sunday morning. Nice, balmy 20 degrees. Everyone had a wonderful time around the campfire last night. Went to bed. And we woke up with a light, fresh coating of snow. Take a look. There's Rafe Nuke's camouflage Superfly. Good morning, everyone. Morning.
Howdy, howdy.
You know what though? Nice,
nice fire going.
We got the fire going. We just threw the coffee on. We got bunches of bacon, bunches of eggs,
and
rabbits.
Rabbit. We've been all waiting for this rabbit.
It's right over there.
They weren't frozen at all, and you can take them and throw. The, you know, the little ones are easy. You can kick them around inside or under quilts or whatever.
Right.
But it's, well, I've had a full size coffee, 32 ounce. Down in my foot box.
Yeah, that's what I had last night, but it's, yeah. What happens is it ends up migrating out of my ass sometimes.
Catch you later.